If you're not 100% sure of the plant, don't eat it. Due to allergies, this video is for informational purposes only. This video is about daylilies. Daylilies grow in large groups. They have long linear leaves that wrap around the central core with nice orange flowers growing on a single flower stalk. The flowers only bloom for one day at a time. If you cut the plant off close to the ground, you won't completely kill it. It'll grow back up. But that whitish green portion is a very good part of the plant to eat. It has got a high water content, tastes kind of like celery, and I found it quite pleasant. Now if you go further up into the green portion, you're going to find that it starts to get a little bit on the stringier side. So now the flowers I haven't tried yet, but they're supposed to be edible as well.
And right here, we have more daylilies. Just all kinds of them. See how the leaves kind of all come up from the base and spread out, forming almost the base of the leaves where they attach to the plant almost look like they form the stalk. So, and then these leaves will grow up and they start arching down.
On the roots, the corms or swollen root parts are the edible portion. It tastes kind of like a mild water chestnut. When you dig up the roots, you'll find quite a few of them off of a single plant. Clean these up and eat them raw. You can cook them like water chestnuts.
Alright, today we're going to look at a plant called Japanese knotweed, which is what this plant here is. And this one, notice the leaves. If you look at the leaves here, it's got a papery sheath on the back side, kind of wraps around. All right, now these plants can grow to 3 feet tall. It's easy to spot once you know what you're looking for. I've been looking for this for a while and hadn't found it. Then Jamie, Doc, and I were coming out of the woods yesterday, and I look and I'm like, Doc, we walked past this walking in. I mean, look at all this Japanese knotweed sitting here. Now this will grow pretty darn tall, and you can find it by last year's growth, which, again, see how the stem is hollow. Even the young growth here, the stems are hollow. All right. Cut one here. Show you. Now the growing large clusters. I mean, see how it's hollow in there. Red specking on the stem. Now I've heard it tastes like apple. And a sour apple. I don't think so. Alright. But you want to peel off that outer skin. It's a little time consuming. You could use a knife to speed this up, but I found that by using a knife, I lose a lot of the the edible portion. Alright, see how it looks there. Maybe, I think it tastes more lemony than apple-y, but there is a slight apple taste there. Not bad. See how the young leaves look almost diamond shaped. They open up more like this here. Now the leaves will grow, kind of wrap around the base, and has like this little papery sheath around it. But they come out like that, and then the flowers will come out from in between here, and it'll be on a long cluster of white flowers, less than 2 millimeters across. All right. Now I say everything I've read says it's found in disturbed sites. I guess this could be a good disturbed site, but it looks more like a washout to me.